Hello. I'm Parul Gulati. You might have seen me or heard about me, but how many of you here know that there's a book written by me? Well, those of you who don't know, it's fine because I'm still in the process of writing it. I thought you could be my first audience who I could collect some constructive feedback from and also tell you my favorite story from my book. So this book is about a girl who I knew, and to be honest, I did not really like her when I got to know her. She would make everything about herself. She was very unsure, somebody who wasn't herself, and could sometimes be annoying, and she was very hungry for attention all the time. But if you knew a girl like that, would you have liked her? Anyway, let me tell you more about her story. So, we were working on this project together where I met her. It was very difficult to talk to her. She would make everything about herself. Every conversation would eventually become about her. Not, hi, how are you doing? What do you like? Everything is about her. And that would just make me feel that what is wrong with this girl? She was just trying too hard to get liked by everyone. Now, we all know it's not possible. Like, you don't have to like everyone, and not everyone else have to like you in return. So she was disappointed. She was looking for this sort of a validation. Now, validation by definition means recognition and affirmation that a person or their opinions are valid or worthwhile. So when she did not get this recognition in real life, she turned to social media, a parallel reality of her own created by her, with a lot of unknown people hiding behind a username. Here it was easy to get liked by concealing, absolutely concealing who you really are. So one selfie, two filters, and boom, she had 50 to 60,000 people checking her posts, commenting, messaging. Oh my God, you're so beautiful, you're so right, so intelligent. All she ever wanted to hear in her real life. So that was like a dopamine for her, and she was just indulging into this. And some people even wanted to get married to her on social media. Every girl's dream come true, right? Anyway, most of our lives are becoming about this nowadays. Why try so hard in real life when it's so easy to get liked on social media? You know, who needs real people anymore? So by now, she had assumed that being liked is her birthright. And that made her obviously very unhappy, and her life had become even more miserable by now. So by now, she had become a collector. She was collecting fake friends, likes, bad habits, unhealthy relationships, and along the way, without realizing, she was collecting hate, anger, envy, and then came the big D word, depression. If you knew a girl like her, what you would have done? Like, would you have judged her, liked her, or just completely avoided her? You know, because who wants to chill with somebody so plastic? But nonetheless, she was a great concept for my book, a great character, wasn't she? But you might be wondering, how can one person be so obsessed with one thing? How can this character be so very one-dimensional? So I tried to know her better. I tried to figure out who she really was, tried to tap into her past. Not the one she would portray herself to be, but the real one behind all of this facade. Who was she? Well, she hailed from a very small town, had gotten her education from a Hindi medium school, and spent most of her time with herself. She just struggled with the fact that no one understood her. Though she had her parents always around, but you know, they always lived in a denial of confronting each other that they did not get along. It was easier to fight than to resolve. So our protagonist, she was 17 when she moved to Bombay from her small town for work. Now, she had never stepped out of her small town. So now she might have been prepared academically. She could read or write, but she struggled with her spoken English. And most importantly, no one, not even her school or her college prepared her for the real world. So Bombay gave her a big culture shock. She had never stepped out of the small town and straight she moved to Bombay. It was a typical case of out of the frying pan and into the fire. It was extremely difficult to adjust to this lifestyle. She was very embarrassed of who she really was and where she came from. So she would make up these stories about her family and make them seem normal. Not fancier, not better, but normal. Like her father is a very loving and caring father, and mother, well, not so much. She would make her seem very modern. Her worldview of normal life slightly differed from how we are used to living. All her life, she tried to conceal her dysfunctional family and all her problems. But you know, now I don't want to live under a pretense of another girl. It took me a lot of time to accept who I really was and where I came from. I couldn't do that alone. I just hated that annoying, hungry for attention girl. So I couldn't figure it out. I did not know what is wrong with me, why people did not like me. In my case, I required therapy. I know therapy is still a taboo word in our country, but I just feel it's time we get past that ancient way of thinking and consider it as new beginnings into accepting ourselves. So I reached out to a therapist to figure out why people did not like me. Why wasn't I enough for this world to accept me? I went on to this quest to only figure out that the only person I hadn't liked or accepted was me. I did not want to accept where I came from and how my journey had been different from most of the people around me. Rather than coming to terms with it, I constantly tried to fit into this normal version of me, which, let me tell you, was the most abnormal person you would ever meet. So my therapist made me realize what I was doing wrong was not valuing what I already had. Like my mother, who stood by me, fought for me to put me in a better school, I took her for granted. My A category friends. Now you might wonder, what is A category? A category people are those who will always be there for you and you'll always be there for them, like your 4 a.m. buddies or your parents. B category are those who you meet every day, your colleagues, your work friends, but you know, you're not like aware of their day-to-day lives. C category are just your acquaintances. So what I was doing was, I was putting my A category people on the side, assuming they will always be there for me, you know, like they're my A category people. Whereas I was trying to get B and C category people to like me. So this obviously made me so unhappy, almost made me hate myself. So this was the point I stopped collecting and I started connecting. My therapist had brought to my notice that I lacked empathy. Now, this is something that happens when we are young. Everything happens when we are young if we don't tap it then. Anyway, so whenever I had a conversation with anybody, it was difficult for me to relate with them, to understand where they were coming from, because maybe when I was young, I just felt not understood. So it took me a lot of time. So if I would have a conversation with you, I would only hear you so that I could reply back. So there was not a conversation, it was just one-way street where I was just talking about myself. But my therapist made me own up to who I was, who I am, and where I came from. I know it is not easy when you feel the whole world is out there to get you. Why? Because you don't like yourself. Just have a real talk with the real person that you are. Tap into yourself. Don't collect. just connect. In my case, I've learned to ask myself, why am I feeling the way I'm feeling? You know, it's a small incident recently occurred. I was driving past a school, and within 3 seconds, like, my brain went so fast, like, I'll tell you what all happened. I just felt a sense of sadness, and I just couldn't figure out what happened. But then I'm like, oh, I'm seeking therapy. Let me just put two and two together. What happened here? I drove past a school, saw a lot of kids step out of the school, run to their parents, and in these 3 seconds, my brain was thinking, oh my God, when I was in the school, nobody came to pick me up. Okay, fine, let's think about the future. Okay, when I will have my kids, will I be able to take care of them? Will I be able to put them in a better school? No. Will I be able to find a father for them who loved them as because my father did not love me? So, do you see the connection, how your brain runs so fast when you feel sad or happy? Within 1 second, your brain comes to a conclusion that you are feeling sad because of that. And a lot of times we cannot figure it out why we are feeling sad. Happy, yes, we know why we are feeling happy. But in this case, you've got to ask yourself, why are you feeling the way you are feeling? And be a good listener when you talk to your friends. Give them an ear too. And if you feel the way I have felt, just talk. Just talk to your parents. Talk to your A-category friends, because they are the ones who will understand you. And most of all, love yourself. At this age, we tend to indulge into self-loathing. We look outside that how others are living the life of their dreams, and we stop appreciating who we really are.